हेलो फ्रेंड्स, गुड आफ्टरनून एवरीबॉडी। टुडे स्टार्ट विथ द न्यू टॉपिक फॉर द सब्जेक्ट फार्मास्यूटिक्स, सो कॉल्ड टॉपिकल एजेंट्स। नाउ जनरली एज यू ऑल नो अबाउट टॉपिकल प्रिपरेशंस, सो कॉल्ड टॉपिकल एजेंट्स, दीज ऑल टॉपिकल एजेंट्स are all topical preparations, they are intended to be used over the skin. They are to be used externally, and when they use externally, they shows their effect. It might be a cosmetic effect, it might be a therapeutic effect, and all are homogeneous preparations will show a smooth consistency, will shows different therapeutic actions, will shows different cosmetic actions, they show a systemic effect on the skin when they are to be used externally. Thodkyat, all topical preparations, they are used only by external application. They are not to be used internally, but they are to be used externally only. And they are homogeneous one. There are emulsion based preparations. Emulsion might be W by O, O by W, or anything other type, but these all emulsions are homogeneous preparations extended to be used over the skin, which shows therapeutic as well as cosmetic properties. Related with these fundamentals, some other time they are not showing a non-therapeutic, they are also not showing non-therapeutic use. They may show a therapeutic as well as non-therapeutic use, but various categories of drugs used topically, they shows anti-inflammatory action, they shows antibiotic action, they shows anti-pruritic action, antifungal action, keratolytic action, protective action, emollient, counter irritant, rubefacient. Variety actions are to be developed when they are used over the skin, when they are used on the surface layers of the skin, and then they show their medicinal uses, so called therapeutic uses. They may containing one or more active ingredients, they may containing one or more than that of one active ingredients, which are to be dissolved with oil, which are to be dissolved with aqueous media, or so called with a suitable base. They have to be dissolved with a suitable base and normally presented in the form of cream, ointment, major creams, ointments, gels. They all are topical preparations, shows therapeutic as well as non-therapeutic use, shows cosmetic as well as therapeutic uses. And therapeutic uses like je atta bollami, anti-inflammatory, antibiotic, antifungal, antipruritic, anti-inflammatory, protectant, ointment. Some different therapeutic uses are to be there with topical application preparations. They are to be supplied in the form of creams, in the form of ointment, in the form of gels, like this. Out of these different types of topical preparation, today we start with first two topical preparations. Number one, ointment, and second, creams. Pahila kutla ointment, dusra asal te cream. When we start with the ointments, these ointments are defined as they are the homogeneous preparations. First one, start with ointment. All ointments are homogeneous preparations. They are intended to be used externally, and external applications of these preparations are to be used over the surface of a skin. And when they use over the surface of a skin, they shows very smooth texture material. And when they are applicable over the skin, some are to be used to protect the skin. Some shows emollient, rubefacient, counter irritant action, And these all preparations, when they use externally, they show therapeutic as well as prophylactic effect. They are smooth in texture. They are stable at a variable temperatures. They are non-greasy. They are easily wiped out through the skin. They do not stain the skin. They are physically stable and they are uniformly distributed when they are to be used over the skin. And when they are uniformly distributed, then they show their therapeutic uses. And that's why these ointments are defined as they are homogeneous semi-solid preparations intended for external application to the skin or mucous membrane. They are used for external application of the skin or mucous membrane and will provide emollient action, counter-irritant action, rubefacient action or soothing effect they may show. As per this definition, ointments are classified into three classes. On the basis of their penetration, they are divided into three classes. Number one, epidermic. Second, endodermic ointment. And third, diadermic ointment. First one is epidermic ointment. They are to be classified on the basis of their penetration. And as per the penetration, the first class is epidermic ointments. Epidermic ointments. And if I say epidermic, dermis means skin. Dermis means skin. And these epidermic ointments are the one that are to be used only over the skin. They do not absorb by the skin, but they are to be used over the skin. When they are used over the skin, they show their action, so called epidermic. And generally, all epidermic ointments are protective, antiseptic in their action. They are not to be absorbed by the skin. They are not to be absorbed into the skin, but they protect the skin. They show antiseptic action to the skin. That is so called epidermic. Second, endodermic. Second class is endodermic. If I say endodermic type of ointment, these are the ointments which are to be used externally, which are to be intended to be used on the surface of a skin, but when they are to be added over the skin, they are absorbed by the skin. They are absorbed into the skin, and when they absorb into the skin, then they show their effect. That means they go into the skin, epidermic, they are used externally, endodermic also used externally, no doubt. But in a case of epidermic, these are the ointments, they are used over the skin, not to be absorbed by the skin. But in a case of endodermic, these are used externally, which when rub over the skin, which when move over the surface of the skin, they are absorbed by the skin. And when they absorb by the skin, then they show their action by dissolving into the skin. Generally, these are the ones. They show emollient action, they show counter-irritant action, they show a stimulant action also. All emollient, stimulant, action containing therapeutic uses, they all are endodermic ointment. Third one, diadermic. These diadermics are not endodermic or epidermic, but they are to be used over the skin. They passes through the skin. They passes through the skin and produces a systemic effect. All diadermic ointments are the one. They passes through the skin and they shows the systemic effect. These are the three major classes. Pahla, epidermic. All ointments are used externally. But if I say epidermic, not to be absorbed by the skin. They use over the skin only. Some so-called protective antiseptic creams. If I say endodermic, second class, they are used over the skin. They are intended to be used on the surface of a skin, but they absorb by the skin and then they show their action. Like emollient, all emollient, emollient ointments or stimulant ointments, they are endodermic. Diadermic, they are used over the skin, but they pass it through the skin and then show their systemic effect. These are the three major classes of ointment on the basis of their penetration. Whereas the second class is ointment on the basis of their therapeutic uses. Therapeutic means treatment. And these ointment which are used by therapeutic treatment, by therapeutic classes, they are number one, antibiotic ointment. Pahila ka hai, antibiotic ointments are the one, they shows the action of medicaments by killing the microbes. By killing microorganisms, they are showing their action. These ointments are used, showing their action by killing the microorganism over the skin, so-called antibiotic ointments. Second, antifungal ointment. Dusra ka se, antifungal ointments. Against fungal, these are the ointments which when used over the skin externally, they are capable to kill the fungus. They are capable to kill the fungus, that is so-called antifungal ointment. Third one, anti-inflammatory ointment. Third one, anti-inflammatory ointment. If I say anti-inflammatory ointments, these are the ointments which when used over the skin, they are capable to absorb, they are capable to shrink the body tissues of a skin, and they produces a proteinous effect over the skin. They precipitates the protein of the skin like keratin, so-called astringent ointment. And if I say anti-inflammatory, these are the one which will rub over the skin. They are capable to protect the skin against inflammation. They are capable to get relief from the inflammation. They get relief from the inflammation, so-called anti-inflammatory. And if I say astringent ointment, these are the one which will rub over the skin. Which will rub over the skin. They shrink the proteinous nature of the skin. The protein present in the skin is keratin. They precipitate the keratin by shrinking the tissue of a skin. That is so-called astringent ointment. Then antipruritic. Antipruritic ointment. These are the ointments which when used externally over the skin, they prevent the itching to the skin. Itching means khaj yani. Itching means khaj. They prevent the itching to the skin, so-called antipruritic ointments. Then keratolytic ointment. Purcha kaya chalte? Keratolytic ointments. These are the ointments which when used over the skin, they are capable to remove the horny structure or horny layer of a skin. These are the ointments which when rubbed over the skin, they remove, neglect the horny layer of the skin, so-called keratolytic ointment. Telagonomy, keratolytic ointment. Nantar asel protectant ointment. Nantar ka asel the protectant ointment. These protectant ointments are the one which when rub over the skin, they are capable to protect the skin against atmospheric air, moisture, dust, grease or different types of contaminants. Against that contaminants, they protect the skin. They are the protective in nature, so-called protectant ointments. One more is that anti-dandruff ointment. One more is a anti-dandruff ointment. The word itself implies. These are the ointments which protect the skin against dandruff. Which protect the skin against anti-dandruff. They are acts as a anti-dandruff. They treat against the dandruff of the skin. Manjaskar, these all are the classes or examples of ointments on the basis of therapeutic uses. Kutle kutle, just to repeat, antibiotic ointment, antifungal ointment, anti-inflammatory ointment, astringent ointment, anti-dandruff ointment, anti-pruritic ointment, keratolytic ointment, and protectant ointment. These all are the different ointments to be used as per their classification. Now, once you know the classification, there are the different advantages of ointment. The first advantage of ointment, ointments are the one they are to be used over the unconscious patients who are not able to collect by the oral administration or by injectables. All unconscious patients are easily to be useful such ointment for the treatment. Second, These ointments are to be used over the infected area only. Whenever there is any part which is infected, only with the infected area, they are to be used. Third one, there is no any necessity for a dose. Accuracy of a dose is not to be accepted in the ointment. Next, they are more stable. They are what? More stable. They show a prolonged effect on exposure. They do not show any sort of a side effect. They show the prolonged effect over the skin. One more. These are the one, they are more flexible in a dose. These are the one, they are more flexible in a dose. One more, they are more stable than that of a liquid dosage form. They are more stable than that of a liquid dosage form. Next, they are easy to storage, easy to transport, no breakage is there. These all are the advantages of ointment. Regina, disadvantages. The first one disadvantage is they may be showing the staining problem over the skin, which when rub over the skin, they may stain the skin. They may be the showing the staining over the skin. That is a major disadvantage. Second one, all ointments are to be used over the skin by using a fingertips. Manual application of ointment is to be there over the finger by using the fingertips. And that's why whenever we use ointments by the use of finger, there may be the chances of contamination. There may be the chances of contamination. This is the major disadvantage. Third one, these ointments, they are very less in accuracy in a dose. Less accuracy of a dose because no fixed dose is applicable for the ointment, and that's why they are less accurate in a dose. Next, they are physically less stable than that of a solid dosage form. Physically, they are very less stable than that of a solid dosage form. These all are the disadvantages of ointment. Less stable cell, contamination of the, there may be the staining of the skin. They are very less stable than that of solid dosage form. No accuracy of a dose is to be there. Due to the fingertip, there may be the chances of contamination. They are very less stable than that of solid dosage form. These all are the disadvantages of ointment. Whereas all ointments are to be stored in a storage conditions, all ointments are to be stored only in wide mouth container at a temperature 20 to 25 degree centigrade, to be stored in a tightly closed container. Tightly closed wide mouth containers are to be useful for the storage of ointments at a temperature 20 to 25 degree temperature. They are to be stored at this temperature, then and then only they maintain their potency for a longer time. That is the detail for the first topical preparation, so-called ointment. Definition zali, classification on the basis of penetration, on the basis of therapeutic uses. Then some advantages, some disadvantages, that is to be studied. And in a storage, all ointments are to be stored only with wide mouth container, wide mouth tightly closed container at a temperature 20 to 25 degree centigrade. That is the whole about ointments. Now the second one, topical application, cosmetic preparation, that is a cream. Second one is a cream. As you all know about a cream, creams are homogeneous preparation. They are also the homogeneous preparation, and they are to be used on a certain mucous membrane showing protective, therapeutic and prophylactic uses. All these creams which are homogeneous in nature, which are semi-solid preparations, homogeneous preparations and semi-solid preparations, and which when used over the skin, they shows therapeutic application, they shows prophylactic application, they shows protective application over the skin. And all the creams which are emulsion, but the nature of emulsion, they might be O by W emulsion, they might be W by O emulsion, but these all are emulsion used externally, and these all are the one, they are very smooth in texture. They are smooth texturized preparations They are viscous in nature, and these creams are the one they are defined as. They are homogeneous, viscous or semi-solid preparations, and which are to be used externally over the skin, and they are either in the nature of oil in water or water in oil emulsions. And these emulsions, OYW emulsions, WYO emulsion, these are the types of emulsions, but by using such a types, creams are prepared, and these creams are homogeneous preparation. They are a semi-solid preparations. They are smooth in texture, stable in air, easy to application, easy to apply over the skin by the way of rubbing, by the way of just using over the skin. They are very smooth in texture. All are in the nature of emulsion. All are in the nature of emulsion. This is the definition for emulsion. That means creams are homogeneous preparations which are viscous liquid or semi-solid liquids which are to be consistent in nature, smooth in texture, and prepared by the way of emulsion, might be in the form of OYW emulsion or WYO emulsion. And these emulsions, opposite cream, or these type of emulsions used for the preparation of cream, and these creams are then used over the skin with by rubbing the skin or just by applying over the skin. This is about the cream. This is the definition of a cream. Once you know the definition, these creams are classified in three classes. Number one, oily creams. Second, watery aqueous creams. And third one, cosmetic creams. And fourth one, medicated creams. There are four classes of a cream. First class is oily creams. If I say oily creams, the word itself implies. These are the creams which are hydrophobic in nature. These are the creams of Manjesh. These are the creams. They are hydrophobic in nature. They are WYO emulsions. These all creams are, oily creams are hydrophobic in nature. They are WYO emulsions, and usually they are anhydrous and absorb only in a small amount of water. Generally, if I say hydrophobic, means water repellent. Hydrophobic, water repellent. If I say hydrophobic, so called water repellent, means they are not capable to dissolve with the water. Very less amount of aqueous media to be applicable to be used for the preparation of such a cream, which are oily cream, which are WYO emulsions. Second one, aqueous cream. Second one is a aqueous cream. The word itself implies. These are the creams, they are hydrophilic in nature. Hydrophilic, water loving. Hydrophilic, water loving. And if I say hydrophilic, these are the ones, they are OYW emulsions. They are what? OYW emulsions. They are the ones, they use over the skin by absorbing excessive amount of water. They are to be prepared because they are hydrophilic in nature. They are water loving in nature. All variety cold creams, vanishing cream, moisturizing cream, they all are aqueous cream. They are what? Aqueous cream. Then third one is a cosmetic cream. Third one is a cosmetic cream. And these are the one, they are WYO or OYW emulsions, but they are used as a cosmetic preparation. They are used as a cosmetic preparation. They might be OYW emulsion or WYO emulsions, but they are a cosmetic preparation like cold cream, vanishing cream, moisturizing cream, body creams, variety creams are there. They are third one, that is a cosmetic cream. Last one, medicated cream. Last one is what? Medicated creams. All medicated creams, the word itself implies. These are the creams. They are used as a medicament by rubbing over the skin. Citramide cream, zinc oxide cream, these all are your medicated creams, which when rub over the skin, they acts as a medication. They shows the medication application over the skin. They shows a therapeutic use. They shows a medicament's action by rubbing over the skin. Like citramide cream, zinc oxide cream, they all are a medicated cream. That means these four are the classification of cream. Number one, oily cream, aqueous cream, cosmetic cream and medicated cream. These are the four types of classes of cream. Now once you know with the classification, some advantages and disadvantages of a cream is there. All creams are stable. They are homogeneous in nature. They are semi-solid in nature. They are in the form of emulsion prepared by W by O or O by W. This is the one sort of summary so called. But in advantages, all creams are deliver the drugs with a low aqueous solubility. They deliver these drugs over the skin easily. Second one, they shows a prolonged effect by application over the skin. They shows a prolonged effect. They shows a long time effect. They shows the sustained effect for a longer time when you use with the applicable, when we use over the skin. Third one, they are washable. They are less greasy and easy to wipe. Easy to remove from the skin. They are non-greasy. They are washable. They do not stain over the skin. They are invisible when they are rubbed over the skin. That means they are non-greasy. They are washable. They are easily wiped out through the skin. Next one. These are the one. They are easily spread up. Easily apply. And they spread more easily over the skin. They easily apply over the skin and easily more stays, easily spread up over the skin. These all are the advantages of a skin. Advantages of a skin. Now once you know the advantages, some disadvantages, all creams are very less stable. They are unstable thermodynamically. They are emulsions, but they are unstable. They are what? Unstable. Second one, these creams causes irritation on exposure to light. They may cause irritation when they expose over the light, and there is no any accuracy of a dose. They are difficult in by at the time of use of exact quantity of cream is very difficult because there is no any accuracy of a dose. These all are the disadvantages of cream. They are unstable. Thermodynamically, the emulsions are unstable. Second one, no accuracy of a dose is there. Third one, they may cause irritation while exposure to the sunlight. These are the disadvantages. In advantages, we what like easy for application. They are easily get spread up throughout the skin. They shows a prolonged effect over the skin. They are spread easily over the skin. Then, they do not stain over the skin. These all are the different advantages of a skin. Of a cream. That means some advantages, some disadvantages for the creams. That is, these are these one. Once you know the advantages and disadvantages, the storage condition, all creams are the one. They are to be stored in a wide mouth container at a temperature 10 to 20 degree temperature. 10 to 20 degree temperature, they are to be stored. Such a creams, they are to be stored in a wide mouth, tightly closed container. They are to be stored in a tightly closed, wide mouth container at a temperature 10 to 20 degree centigrade. This is the whole about creams. That means today we were competing with the ointment as well as creams. Ointment's explanation and creams explanation. That ends with the two topics. Now next time we start with some gels and the next one, that is nasal suppositories, pessaries, some topical application preparations that we'll see by next time. Aaj fakta zalaka hai, ointment adi cream. Is that clear? Thank you.